Ellis with Tormach, and today I'm going to go over a quick setup using the 6-inch tilting table with a 2-jaw chuck. It's just going to be a little quick setting up this aluminum block. Now I've prepped the piece we're going to set up. I milled the end square to the sides. What I'm going to do is put a set of parallels against the face of the chuck, because if you look, these little the hard jaws that are on the chuck, they stick out beyond the 2 jaws. So if I just tried to clamp on my piece, it would clamp on those hard jaws. So if I space it out with these parallels, it'll square us up to the face of the chuck, and then I'll just be clamping using the jaws. So now I'm going to hold it in against the parallels, and then I'm just going to lightly tighten the chuck. Because then what I'm going to do is take and tap it with a hammer to center it roughly. Depending on your workpiece, it may not be that important for you to center it. You might be able to just scale it in from the side of the jaws. But I'm just going to show you how I would center it if I wanted it centered pretty close. I've centered the axes of the machine to the center of the chuck. I did that already. I just swept the outside of the chuck. I knew the chuck was running good, so I swept the outside, and that's what I'm going to call zero in this. I'm just going to roughly zero the A axes, so it's partially square, just so I got something to start with, and then I'll fine tune it after I get the part. It's close enough for what I'm doing. I'll go back to the Y zero on the readout. Turn my indicator. The first trial, you don't have to be that close because you don't know how far you're going to have to tap it over. But I got the readout on the machine zero, indicator zero. Now if I check the other side of the part, see I got to tap it over. We'll see how far off it is. Back to zero. 176 thousandths off. Dial it over to 88 thousandths. I zeroed the indicator on the back side. It shifted towards the back. And then if I come and check it on the front side, maybe the 176 thousandths. I'm at 40 now. Almost, I had to move my indicator. So now if I move it to the 70, now I can just tap my part over. Hold it up against the parallels.
it's pretty close.
Got the DRO reading zero, and then our indicator reading zero on the front and the back. Now I'll tighten the chuck. Zero the A axes now. That's pretty good. And then just zero the A axes on your DRO. If I was doing, you know, something that was really fussy, I'd index it 180 degrees and see how well centered it was. These two jaw chucks are on a scroll plate, so the jaws are going to come in together off the scroll plate. So if you find that your piece is shifted, the only way to center it is to add some shim stack to the vice jaw to get it centered. It just depends on how fussy your workpiece is that you're doing. If you're just machining some artwork on a piece of plywood, I wouldn't even bother using an indicator. Just throw it in, let the chips fly. Good. Anything else you want to see?
Is that it?
That's the quick and easy way.
Is there a long way?
Yeah, but a lot of it ends up being repetitious to what we showed at the four jaw and the three jaw setup.
Okay.
As far as indicating the whole head and all that stuff, those other videos showed that. So this is just dialing in a workpiece on the two jaw chuck.
Good. Cool. Thank you.
Okay. One last thing. After you have everything dialed in and you're happy with it, don't forget to remove your parallels, because they won't be tight and they'll fall out just when it's indexing, and they'll bind up and everything will be thrown off. So that's the last little tip.